Plenty of working people complain their jobs drive them out of their minds. But at the stave company in Norwich, workers are encouraged to drive customers out of their minds. Ted explains.
Earlier, we mentioned how nice the locals are in this area, but we take that all back because some folks here take great pleasure perplexing and puzzling people.
You didn't tell me there was going to be a test here today, okay?
I'm a tormentor.
It's a title Paula Tardy and her colleagues at Stave Puzzles wear with pride. Steve Richardson and Dave Tibbett started the company in 1974. Steve still runs things and is always thinking of new ways to delight his customers.
Steve, we call him the Chief Tormentor, and he lives up to his name.
Teasers, tricks, 3D puzzles, and no picture to follow, mind you. Just a blue box with a clown seemingly laughing at your efforts. While torture is fun, customer service is important at Stave. Employees are always available to answer questions and offer encouragement.
We hear that very often. I'm down to 5 pieces, and these pieces are not going into my puzzle, so there's definitely a piece missing.
And what do you say? Okay,
just, you know, buy some M&Ms, refresh your puzzling power, and look at it again.
The advice is included with the puzzles, which can cost hundreds or even thousands of dollars. Each one is made of Vermont wood and handcrafted by highly trained carvers here.
Very long apprenticeship to learn how to do everything perfect before we can sell the puzzle.
Do you make them in different levels of sadism?
All the puzzles have a difficulty rating. If you're working on a traditional puzzle, what determines the difficulty would probably be the size and usually the image. So if you've got a lot of sky, that's going to take you more time than if you've got a lot of different colors to work with.
So obviously you have one single color throughout, that's got to be maddening.
That is very maddening. And this one is Fan Flare, and it's a fan favorite. People open this box, they have all the same color pieces in here, they dump them out, and they're just not quite sure where to begin. So these are trick puzzles. Some of these pieces fit in more than one place, but there's only one correct solution. So for example, this is Fishbowl Frenzy. The cats belong on the outside of the bowl and the fish belong inside the bowl. And you have to figure out how to rearrange all of that to make it fit. This is Seeing Stars.
Uh-huh.
It's made up of all starfish.
Yes.
And so it's a true
yes.
challenge, this puzzle.
So I see exactly how this goes together. Let me see how good you are. There's only 3 pieces left.
Only 3 pieces.
And neither one of us can figure out how
that's
that goes.
Right.
Even expert puzzlers get stumped by Stave's creations.
I don't like trick puzzles. I find them very frustrating. I love the teasers, but you see, everybody likes different kinds, so that's why they're in business here.
I've had people send me pictures of them doing puzzles around a counter where there's 5 or 6 teenagers. All the phones are down and everybody is conversing or paying attention to each other and actually being together.
If you know the Dartmouth Green, you may have noticed recent changes, particularly at the Hood Museum of Art, temporarily relocated to Main Street.
The Hood Museum of Art facility is currently closed for a major renovation and expansion. It's a very mission-centric expansion that we're doing right now, and also includes 5 new exhibition galleries, which we're very excited about.
Juliet Bianco is a Dartmouth grad and deputy director of the Hood Museum. The downtown gallery, she says, helps maintain the museum's presence for the region. On display during our visit, photography of Julie Blackman.
So this work is from her recent series where she photographs members of her family in situations that seem domestic at first glance, but then the more you look at the little details and what's happening in the photographs, you realize that there's something a lot more intriguing going on.
The Hood Museum is the only world-class art museum, Bianco notes, for more than 100 miles, a fact not lost on her.
Art connects people, helps us understand each other more. The older I get, the more important I think that is.
A new exhibit at the museum's downtown gallery replaces Julie Blackman's photography. This one, Portraits by Nigerian artist Toyin Odutola, comes from the Whitney Museum in New York City. The museum itself is scheduled to reopen in January. And even more trickery from the Stave puzzle makers. The company rates each puzzle's difficulty by number, 1 to 4. Now, for the first time ever, they've created a puzzle that ranks 5 on the difficulty scale. Whew. Well, these houses represent a new beginning for Norwich.
By calling attention to them, we hope to help preserve them.